Come on, man, you can do it. You can do it. 1 mile an hour. Throw her into low, big guy. Let's go. We're going up the hill. You and me. We can do this. It's going to be a thing. Hammer on it, buddy. Hammer on it. Hammer on it. Give her some. Going backwards. 0 miles an hour. This isn't working out.
Hey, baby. What's the matter? Don't you like farmers?
What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here. And we found people hanging out today, doing some of the things, playing Farm Simulator 2015. And I did make it up the hill finally. Now, I tested. I went back down that hill. And I went around to the flour mill. I went ahead and dropped off the load there. I wanted to drop it off here at Uncle Pete's Excellent Diner, which is open 24 hours a day and is air conditioned. So I wanted to come up here because the pricing for our wheat up in this area is better. You can see here's our wheat. Oh, right here, $12.04 for the diner. Wait, what? And then for the flour meal, we're getting $200 less, $125 less per ton there. And I think that the train station's a little better. But I wanted to come up here. I haven't been up here yet, and I thought it'd be cool. It looks like a really great area. It's like so well made, very, very awesome. But a lot harder to get up here. So I think the AgroStar 661 tractor just isn't cutting it for this. We might have to get into a new tractor eventually, or just not come to the diner until then. But I've done all my stuff and things back at my wheat field. Let's go ahead and let's see here. Oh, I heard there's something else that we can do. Let me see if we can do this. Check this out. So if we go to tractors, AgroStar, reset. Wait, hold on. No. So let's go back here. If we disconnect this, check this out. So we're all the way up here at the diner, right? So if we go I and then reset vehicle tool, yes, reset. And then we go to harvesters, tools and trailers, and then we find this guy, reset, yes, okay, bam. Now we're up here and there's nothing here, where did it go? So if you reset, if you go into your I menu, into vehicle selector, and then hit reset tool, it automatically brings your stuff and things back to your farm right here. So that's like a really good, cheat, because you can move things around a lot faster that way. It's kind of cheaty. All right, so let's check out what's going on in our field here. We've got all of our rows. Everything's ready to go here. So what do we need? We need our windrower and our baling technology, that stuff and things to come over here. Let's go ahead and grab this tractor and get him out of the way a little bit. We don't want you in the way for this, buddy. I love this tractor. I love that this tractor is more quiet. Like, I don't know what it is about it, but I love that it's like a quieter tractor. It just feels cooler, and it's so much faster. So we need some better tractors. All right, but we want to go over to the shop and go ahead and get some stuff and things purchased. So we're going the wrong way a little bit, but that's fine. We can go this way. Oh, the what? All right, that's not the button for cruise control, by the way. That is the button for getting out of your tractor. It's a little bit different of a button. But yeah, we're having a good day. I hope you guys are having a good day too. And like I said, I've said it before and I'll say it again. I don't know why this game is fun and I can't stop playing it. And I've said this before too, I think it's just because I really want to see what the better stuff is. Like, more than anything, I want to just get into some better tractors and some better, like, equipment. So you feel the need to, like, grind in it, which, I don't know, it's just cool and fun. I'm spending a little bit too much time. I should probably be over in Hermitcraft. But hey, whatevs. We just love it too much. All right, so here we are. Let's go ahead and get P. Let's get our windrowers, and we're going to get the biggest one. Let's go ahead and buy that guy. Bam, we got it. All right, and then back. We want to go for baling technology, and then also the other thing is I want to get into silage, so we're going to buy this too. Bam! And we're good to go. We still have $276,000. Now, if we take a look at tractors, let's see here. The next guy up from the case is the Lambo. The Lambo we could get into, but we might want to wait a little bit. Let's wait and see what happens. We got a couple of new toys now. Oh, baby. Let's check these things out, man. So let's go ahead and head out and take a look here. The Crone. Look at this thing. It looks like a spice machine. Oh, and it's got a squirty light. It's got a light. It's not a squirty light, but it's got a light. And then look at this guy. Looks like a super seat. It's like the best seat ever. All right, so we got to get both of these guys over to our farm. Let's go ahead and try the Windrow out straight away. So let's get this guy on the tractor and check it out. Now, there's no, like, requirement for weight, I don't believe, or horsepower for this guy at all. It's all kind of based on the tractor tech. So that's how fast it's going to work. It's going to work as fast as the tractor works. So let's take it here. On our way over, let's unfurl. What do we got here? Lower it, turn it on, and unfurl. So let's go ahead and unfurl this bad boy. Are you unfurling? Wait, it won't unfurl. Oh, there it is. It's unfurling. Oh, ooh, oh, oh my God. Look at it. It's amazing. What are you? Space machine. All right, let's get over here and check this thing out. This thing is massive. So how many rows can we do at once? It looks like, oh, baby. Oh, baby, baby, baby. We may need to put a weight on. Ooh, I don't have a weight. Oh, this thing is going to be hard to control. All right, let's check it out. Let's get you in a turn. All right, there we go. Let's try to get lined up here. Stupid cars everywhere on our farm. Come on, guys. I'm trying to work here. No, you're going to have to wait. Are you seriously going to do that? Did that just happen? Stupidest car ever. Oh, you jerk. Oh, no, car. Ugh, get out of the way, man. Oh, I'm trying to work here, man. All right, I think we can get three rows at once. Let's get lined up. I feel like we're going to be able to get three of these guys. Let's go ahead and turn it on. Oh, my God. Lower it. Are we going to be able to get all three of these? Oh, crap. We can't get all three. Oh, man. All right, so let's lift it up and back up. Looks like we're going to have to do two rows at a time. I thought this thing was the hotness, but I feel like maybe I was gypped. All right, we'll just get the two rows at once. This should be fine. It'll be fine, but at least it'll save us a little bit of time. Kind of seems silly that it only combines two rows, so I'm basically going to combine two rows, but I have to do two passes in order to do that. I don't know if this really saves us any time, but it's super fun. All right, let's go ahead and get this thing done. So we can squirt down through here like this. And then it's going to combine that into two. It's really cool. I think if we use the higher-end tractor, it'll probably go a little bit faster. But still really fun, right? That's a neat idea. It's just a neat thing, man. But again, because of, like, if we were using a different combine that was putting out more of the hay rows, you know what I mean, closer together, this would be, like, way better. Because then it would probably combine three of them at once. When it only combines two, it's kind of like, why don't we just do two passes with a baler? But we'll see. It's probably still save some time. All right. Ooh. So we're going to come over and get these two guys at once. All right, cool. I feel like I need a faster tractor for this. It'd be a lot quicker. Maybe we'll hook up the case to it. But I think this machine is totally crazy looking. Totally cool. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to row the rest of the field. And then we're going to go grab the... We're going to start baling. Now, the baling technology we have... Oh, you know what? We may be able to afford the better baler. We may be able to afford that better baler. Let's look. 128 for the better baler. And 45, so less than 200 grand for those two pieces of equipment. Are we going to get all this stuff today? I don't know. Maybe we are. This might be an action-packed episode full of new purchases. So what's the windrower called? Let me see. The Sandro 2000. We got the Sandro 2000 rocking and rolling. I'm going to go ahead. You guys have seen the baler. I'm going to go ahead and start baling once we get this done, and then we're going to grab the new silage thing. Yeah, we need the better tractor for this. Look how slow this guy's going up the hill. So I'm going to grab the new tractor, get the baling done, and then I'm going to grab the silage trailer, which is called, we're learning names, I'm telling you, it's going to be the best. The Z586, there's no way I can remember all this stuff. We're going to grab the ZA586 thingy-doodler and see how that works, and then we'll be our bees. And we're back. And you guys, man, with this hay that's, when it's windrowed like this, look how quick it fills up this little baler. Like, I feel like the baling technology is, like, there needs to be better baling technology. This is crazy. Like, it just squirts out a bale, like, every couple of seconds, almost, it feels like. So, it's pretty cool. Like, it definitely makes it a little bit more efficient. I mean, it feels like it's more efficient. I don't know. It's fun, though. That's cool. So, now, like, I gotta be really careful. Like, you can see, like, you fill up so quick. It's crazy, man. So, I've only done a couple of rows here, and then the other thing about this is you'd think that it would bale, I guess it does has to do them this way. You'd think that they would make it so that it put it on the flat end so they wouldn't roll around on your field, but oh wells, whatever. So look, I mean, it's crazy how fast that fills up. All right, so we're going to finish this row up and then we're going to try the new equipment. Let's go ahead and do this. They have to like be really careful. Like you have to... You have to, like, watch how big it, how, you know, how full your machine is, and then, like, you have to be careful not to go over. Oh, all right. I guess you could wait for it to beep, and then hammer on the brakes. Like that. All right, cool. So squirt this guy out, and I think we could probably get one more. Let's see here. We'll get close to it at least. So, really cool. Super fast this way. Nope. Yep, we definitely got one more. All right, sweet. Oh, and I changed out. I started using the case. I think we're going to get into the other balers in this episode, but new tractor is going to be the order of business after that, big time. We're definitely going to have to buy a new tractor. All right, so we're going to squirt this baler over here, and then we're going to try the silage thingy-doodler, whatever it is. All right, cue that guy out of there. Try this guy out. We're getting a little bit of lag, probably because I'm rendering at the same time. I'm rendering another farming episode right now. All right, we got it. All right, let's check it out. So, unfold round bale wrapper. So, I guess it's only for round bales. And that's kind of what I was wondering about, is if we could do other anything else besides round bales. So what do? We just kind of drive up to it like this. This bale is not supported. Why not? Fold round bale wrapper. It's a round bale wrapper. Why is it not supported? Does it have to be the other direction? Like, do we have to face them all upwards? Because that would be silly if that's the case. I'm trying to see here. I'm trying to think about how this would work. I don't think I could, like, I don't know if I could tip one over. Tip over, man. I could... Oh, yeah, we almost got it. I could go get the tractor and then, like... Oh, we're having a big problem. Oh, this is bad. Oh, we did it. Perfect. All right, do you work now? This bale is not supported. Fold round bale wrapper. Do not understand why it wouldn't work on round bales. That seems so silly. And I think I've seen... Does it only work on grass? Maybe it's only on grass bales. All right, we're having a big problem here. Let's go ahead and fold this thing back up. Maybe we can only turn grass into silage. That might be what's going on here. So we'll have to find out. I don't have any mowers, so I don't know. But I'm guessing that that might be the case. And it makes sense, too, because you kind of couldn't ferment probably dried hay. That doesn't seem like a thing that can happen. All right, so that means that it's probably time for us to do some other bales. Let's go ahead and buy some other baling technology. I think that it would be really fun to do that today. Because I know that the new baler has, like, it has a butt. And it squirts bales off its butt cloaca. Which pretty much is in keeping with everything that goes on YouTube.com/SlipGator. So, it's definitely appealing for us. Let's go ahead and check it out. Well, let's go ahead and buy it. I think we should have enough to do it. Yeah, 128 and 45. So we can do both of these guys. Let's go ahead and get this guy. And let's go ahead and get this guy. We has all the baling technology. All right, let's head back. And they should be over here. Ooh, new toys. So many new toys. God, we're blowing through the money. And we still have 100 grand. Ugh, I'm so glad I grind like a fiend. All right, what do you guys look like? Let's check it out. Oh, the New Holland Big Baler 1290, baby. I remember you from when I was a kid on the farm and we used to bale things. No, I don't. See, I worked on a farm when I was a kid. I don't remember anything like this. The Auto Stack Arcusin. They have such baller names. It's got a little place for all of your tools for when your thing breaks down, but it doesn't ever break down because it's amazing. All right, let's grab the baler. So yeah, like I was saying, I hear this thing's got a butt cloaca. I'm not exactly sure, so we're going to find out right now. Also, it feels like this tractor gets less dirty. All right, let's do it. Come here, buddy. Ooh, you're a little heavy. Ooh, ugh. A little big in the back end there, baby. All right, let's head out of here. All right, let's unfold the baler. Let's unfurl it. Ooh, there's its butt cloaca. It looks like a little mouth kind of person. Looks like a little guy, maybe. All right, if we turn on our lights, maybe the cars will get out of our way. All right, let's turn on the baler. Wow, we're moving. And we just lowered the pickup. Ooh, something's wrong. Abort. We didn't lower the pickup, I guess. I pushed the lower the pickup button. Oh, baby. The axial flow 7160 is failing us. Oh my God, we're gonna need a better tractor like right away. I can't believe it. Maybe if we turn the lights off, we'll get a little bit more power. Oh yeah, totally helped. All right, we lowered the pickup. Let's turn around here. Let's get lined up. Let's not go too fast. Let's see how this thing works. All right, here we go. All right, it's making a bale. Oh, it's squirting it out of its butt cloaca. Oh, here it comes. Ooh, it made one. Oh, it's just like pooping out a whole line of bales. It's like a big bale pooper. This is the best. Yeah, just poop them out, man. And we can just go at full speed when we do this. Oh, cool. I think we can go at full speed. Oh, yeah, man, this is awesome. I'm kind of amazed by it. I'm like speechless right now by how awesome this thing is. Oh, it's too bad there's no silage for this or anything like that. Cause this is way more efficient than using the round bales as far as like the speed at which you can make them. That's crazy cool. Look at it, it's squirting out. Oh, it feels like a real farming thing. It's like a real thing. Those bales look awesome too. Look how detailed they are. Oh, I'm inside of its butt. Oh, this is what the inside of a machine butt looks like. And we're going slow now. But yeah, this is super fast. All right, this is rad. So yeah, and then obviously better tractor is coming. We're gonna need that next. So we're gonna have to grind out a bunch more stuff and things. But that's fine, that's totally cool. That gives me something to do. So, poop it out. Squeeze it. Cut it off, man. Oh, it's like hanging. It's got a hanger. It's got a little will knot. Oh, baby, it's a little will knot. It just will not come off. All right, let's go ahead back around for another pass. I wonder what happens if you disconnect it with this little Klingon hanging out there. If it just stays there forever, what does it do? All right, I think that we're going to want to... I think that we're going to want to maybe switch to round bales. I don't know. We'll play around with this here real quick. So I'm just going to do this last row, and then we're going to go pick up the new trailer too and get that going, see what that's all about. So, all right, I'm going to pick up the new trailer. I'll be RBs. And we're back. I went ahead and grabbed all the round bales and sold those guys off. I think I got like $8,000 or something like that. And then so now we're going to go ahead and grab our square baler, trailer, picker-upper guy, and then try to get out of this terribly designed area. I think you're meant to go out that side, but I don't care, man. That's not the fastest way. So, all right. So this is going to be the square baler, the square bear trailer, square bear trailer. It's really hard to say. It is called Baling Technology. I like how it's called Baling Technology. The AutoStack FS6372. Everybody's got, well, everyone knows the AutoStack FS6372. It's like it's the baling technology of the future. So let's go ahead and stick it into operating position and check this bad boy out right here and see how this works. So I do believe that really the baling is meant to be done in this way for fields. I think for grass, we kind of want to do the rounder bales, and I'll show you why here. Can we just go ahead and pick that guy up? Oh, look how cool that is. Oh my God. All right. Does it need a second? Or is it just good to go right away? Oh no, it needs a second. All right, cool. Oh, it's so neat, man. It's like stacking them up. Check it out. Hold on, let's grab this one right here. And then it's gonna go ahead and stack them back like that. Oh, I wonder how many we can fit. That's 4. I bet it does at least, I bet it does at least 12. It looks like it'll hold 12 or 16. That's crazy, man. Now, we have about 100,000 extra bucks. It needs a second. We got about 100,000 extra bucks. I got that silage baler. I really want to use it. In order to do that, we're going to need, this thing holds a huge amount. It's crazy. All right, so in order to do the silage baler, we need green hay. In order to get the green hay, we're probably going to need to get a mower. So that's something that we can look into here in a second. I think that we might, I don't know, we're really going to blow our wad on equipment today. But I think that we can get into a mower pretty cheap. Holy crap, does this thing hold a lot of bales. I can't even believe how many bales it holds. I think it's more than 16. Let's see. This is why it's so much fun to play this game, because you can just like do stuff all day long. All right, I think we can go. Will it do 2 more or 4 more? And then will you do 2 more or are you full? No, she's full. So that's 2, 4, 6, 8, 12, 14, 16. Is that 18? 2, 4, 6, 8, 12, 14, 16. Yeah, 18 bales. Holy crap. All right, let's go ahead and stick her in transport position and then head to unload all these and see how much cash roll we get for this. That is a huge amount of hay. Look how cool that looks, man. I feel like a real farmer. Ooh, where am I going? Except I'm not really good at driving. But I don't think all farmers are. I don't think it's a prerequisite. Well, possibly. I mean, you possibly could need to be good at driving. So here's the trick, backing this bad boy up. This is going to be tight because this is way bigger than the round baler. All right, let's go ahead and see what we can do. Oh, baby. Oh. Oh, that's it. We're pinned. Oh, we might get it. Perfect. We should. Oh, you really can't do it like that? No way. So you can't back it. Oh, that stinks. So the round baler, you can just back it right in. Oh, you're kidding me, man. This is going to be way harder. Yeah, the round baler, you can just back them right in. And maybe I'm hitting the door. Yes. No. Oh, man. All right, this is going to be super tricky. That is super tight. What a pain in the butt. So you probably need like a front end loader really to do it the right way. Let's just see what we can do here. Oh my God. Oh, this sucks. Man, that's a pain in the nuts. All right. I'm going to play around with this a little bit, and I'll BRB. I'm going to see if I can get this thing backed up into there perfectly. I don't think it's going to be possible. But we'll see. Oh, no, man. Oh, man. I can't do it. All right. We'll see what I can do. I'll be right back. All right. It doesn't get much better than that. Let's see what happens when we unload the bales. We can't get this thing backed all the way in like we can with the round bale loader. Oh, it's pushing me. Oh. Oh, you don't like that, huh? All right. Let's see what happens if we get this thing. What is going on, man? That is like a really poorly designed way to unload these. So let's go ahead and hit O to unload. Okay, we got $3,000. Can we like push them in? What a crappy system. That's terrible, man. Can we get that guy all the way in? Probably not. Oh yeah, we can. I can't remember how much we got. That's way hard to unload. It shouldn't be that way. Like, it should be so much easier. I think that you're meant to use a front end loader. But I feel like on a real farm that you would just, you'd have a better, easier way to do it. I don't know. Maybe I don't know that much about farming. So, all right, we got that going on. We got the round bales. We're having a good time with those. We got the square bales. We're having a good time with those, except for the unloading process. But we got the silage thingy doodler we want to play with too. All right, I'm not sure what we're going to do next, but I'm going to play around with some stuff and things, and I'll BRBs. And we're back, and these guys are just finishing up the last little bits of the field here. Let's go ahead and switch over to our cultivator sower guy, because he's going to go ahead and peace out. There he goes. Peace out, homie. So I thought we might get into mowing and that stuff today, but I don't think we are. I also wanted to maybe get into placing a solar panel, but we just ran out of money. So solar panels cost $125,000. I thought they were $120,000. Now, if you remember when we first started, we placed some beehives. We have bee houses. We have three of these guys making $60 an hour. Now, these solar panels, they make $380 an hour. It's a huge amount of money for them to go ahead and start making, and we should start placing them every once in a while. Well, we did get a huge amount of stuff done today with baling technology. We got into the new baler, the Big Baler 1290. We got into the Ursus Z586. We got into the AutoStack FS6372. But the next thing that we're going to get into is mowing. So we're going to buy this FC3525F and the FC10030 from Kuhn. And we're going to start getting into mowing. As well as that, we're also going to need... Is it under cultivators? No, it's not. It's under Crapo tenders. We're going to need to get one of these too. This Pottinger HIT12.14T. We're going to need one of these to turn our grass over. I think we can let it dry, but we're going to want that too. So we have $124,000. This takes 27, and then the mowers are going to take another, like, what is that, 65? So we got totally enough money to do it already. So that means I'll probably end up harvesting a couple of fields, getting some more money for the next episode. But we're definitely going to play around with grass, baling grass, and silage, and I'm excited. So I hope that you guys are liking all the stuff and things we're doing in Farmington. If you do, make sure you hit the thumbs up button, show your support for the series. Feel free to share and favorite as you see fit. Don't spam on a ride of papes. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day.